The tone of the meeting was something of a surprise. Many expected Warden James Jennings to be in the hot seat. He's been under considerable pressure since the mass escape and ensuing riot at the county jail last month. But a 34-page report issued by Sheriff Eugene Coon showed that the problems at the jail cannot be pinned on any one person. The prison board members made it no secret they seem to agree. Specifically, the report blames a lack of staff and the age of the jail as the biggest problems. Most of the locks and plumbing were installed when the jail was built some 90 years ago, and the electrical system is not much better. Some 12 guard vacancies at the jail have gone unfilled, while the number of prisoners has increased. Jennings feels the board is addressing the major problems, and he thinks his job is secure.
Well, right now we're going to sit down, and just like I said before, with Sheriff Coon, and get this thing and get this thing straight on, see how many men we really do need to run that institution.
What about the possible procedural changes in their shakedowns, things like that?
Yes, well, not going to broadcast that around the city or any place like that, but we'll have quite a few shakedowns.
Board members unanimously passed a motion to implement Sheriff Coon's recommendations and give them a 30-day trial period. More guards will now be hired, engineers will consider the cost and feasibility of repairs, and for the first time, the prisoners may be issued institutional clothing. Up till now, they have been wearing street clothes and can easily get lost in the city after escapes. So far, nobody has proposed building a new jail, but nobody has ruled that out either. Mike Schneider, Channel 4 Action News.
Thing we'll have manpower, and we'll discuss that too. That'd be our first thing to discuss, be manpower.
You're going to get 12 new people over there, 3 people, regular guards, and 9 under the manpower program. Is that adequate as far as ensuring safety over there and discipline?
Well, right now we're going to sit down, and just like I said before, with Sheriff Coon, and get this thing and get this thing straight on, see how many men we really do need to run that institution.
What about the possible procedural changes in their shakedowns, things like that?
Yes, well, we can't, not going to broadcast that around the city or any place like that, but we'll have quite a few shakedowns.
So that the prisoners will be checked out regularly for things?
Well, definitely they'll really be checked out.
Mm-hmm. Well, how's security over there now in the wake of the riot and then the uprising?
Well, the security is real good. Now, you got to realize our officers are working really hard. They're running up and down them steps, and they can only do so much if we don't have the manpower.
There was a talk about getting institutional clothing. What do the prisoners wear now?
Well, they wear their own clothing, but if a few years back, Sheriff Coon ordered them clothing into the jail and never was initiated, but now we're going to initiate it, and we're going to sit down and discuss the colors of each block, and each individual will know where they're at the jail.
Warden, thank you very much. Warden Jim Jennings, by the way, now the warden, and as he says, Sheriff Coon will be sitting down talking to some of the guards as well to find out what kind of changes should be made. There are a great deal of them, 14 specific points. They'll be given a 30-day experiment, go back before the prison board for formal adoption. This is Mike Schneider reporting live with the Channel 4 Action Cam.